Let's continue with the second part of the Population 3 stars, and we will have a talk by Tomoaki Ishiyama. Did I pronounce it correctly?
Yes.
Okay, wow. And he will answer the question, where are all the low mass POP3 stars? So please go ahead.
Yep. Is it okay?
Slide, please.
Hello. Hello, everyone. So I would like to thank organizers for giving us to show our result here. So today I'm talking about where are the low mass POP3 stars. So there are some studies to simulate many number of large number of POP3 stars systematically and by high resolution numerical simulations. And such works show POP3 IMF. POP3, the typical mass of population 3 is about 10 solar mass to a few thousand solar mass. It means the typical mass is very massive as a first approximation. But this means unstable circumstellar disks also can form, and unstable circumstellar disks fragment into small pieces, and they could end up as low-mass population 3 stars. If their mass are less massive than 0.8 solar mass, their lifetime is longer than the age of the universe. So we have to observe it in the Milky Way. But some of low-mass POP3 stars could hold on to the central protostar and merge with it. But on the other hand, some of them could be ejected from the dense central region and ejected from the dense central region and survive at current universe. So it is possible to observe such low mass population 3 stars as survivors in the Milky Way. Thus, low mass population 3 stars are possible. But average number of low mass population 3 stars per mini halo is unknown. So we have to predict theoretically how many population, low mass population 3 stars could survive in the Milky Way in order to constrain the low mass population 3 star IMF by observations. For this purpose, we have to predict the distribution of population 3 stars by the context of Lambda CDM. And then we use numerical model based on hierarchical formation of dark matter mini halos and Milky Way halos taken from single cosmological simulations. And we combine it with recipe for the formation of population 3 stars in H2 cooling mini halos. Then we assume an IMF of low mass population 3 stars. Then we constrain the model in reverse by past and ongoing and planning observations. In our work, we first perform huge cosmological elbow simulations. The mass resolution is about 5 times 10 to the 3 solar mass, and the box size is 8 megaparsec in one length. In this simulation, we can resolve POP3 forming mini halos whose mass is about 10 to the 5 solar mass. And we can also simulate Milky Way sized halo at redshift 0. So from this single cosmological elbow simulation, we can resolve both POP3 forming mini halos and Milky Way sized halo redshift 0. So we can obtain the assembly history of POP3 forming mini halos and their evolution into redshift 0. This is our cosmological elbow simulation snapshot at redshift 0. We only simulated dark matter, so this is dark matter map. Previous studies to predict the distribution of low mass population 3 survivors suffer from poor simulation mass resolution. And some works, some studies use semi-analytic model, but the nature of semi-analytic model, semi-analytic model doesn't give us the spatial distribution of mini halos. So our simulation could give us the worth of spatial distribution of mini halos with sufficient mass resolution in the first time. From this cosmological envelope simulations, we identified mini halos and halos by friends of friends method and generate merger trees. The minimum halo mass is 1.6 times 10 to the 5 solar mass, corresponding to 32 simulation dark matter particles. And we could identify 4 Milky Way sized halos at redshift 0. On this merger tree, we model the formation of low mass population 3 stars. The model is as follows. First, we use the condition of mini halos where POP3 can form as described here. So first, we set the virial temperature of mini halos exceed the threshold T critical virial. And also, we put upper bound of virial temperature 2000 Kelvin to exclude atomic cooling halos. We use virial temperature threshold as shown in this paper and this equations. At here, we consider the condition of collapse of mini halos and the Riemann-Bellner background. In this equation, FLW is Riemann-Bellner background, and we assume it is specially uniform and redshift dependent, and we set it to reproduce cosmological reionization simulations as shown in this paper. Other condition of POP3 forming mini halos, we consider any progenitors of mini halos satisfy this condition. Also, do not satisfy this condition. In this procedure, gas in mini halos is metal free. Final condition we consider is all mini halos should be collapsed before redshift 10. In this sense, we assume about redshift 10, reionization starts. And reionization shuts down the star formation in mini halos. So we stop, list up the mini halos at redshift 10. After this procedure, we have listed up all POP3 forming mini halos. Next, we assume 10 or 1 low mass population 3 stars born per mini halos with the Cropper IMF, the mass from 0.15 to 1 solar mass. Then we randomly select 10 or 1 dark matter particles of mini halos as tracer of population 3 stars. This means the spatial position of dark matter particles of mini halos at redshift 0 is also position of population 3 survivors at redshift 0. Then magnitudes of various bands are calculated by an isochrome model. What you can see from this figure is the number of population 3 low mass population 3 survivors as a function of the halo mass at redshift 0. And blue symbols shows the model with the 1 population 3 stars per mini halo, and red symbols shows 10 population 3 stars per mini halo. Clearly, you can see number of low mass population 3 survivors per halo at redshift 0 is proportional to the halo mass and assuming number of population 3 stars per mini halo. Next, we make all sky map of population 3 survivors observed from sun's position in a Milky Way halos. In our simulations, we obtained 4 Milky Way sized halos. Here, I show one halo result. And we put observers 8.5 kiloparsec from the halo center and, and make a projected number density of all population 3 survivors. This is map obtained from 10 low mass population 3 stars per mini halo models. You can see clearly the central part, in the central part, the survivors show high contrast. On the other hand, this map shows dark matter projected dark matter density per square degree. You can see the distribution is very similar. So we can say the distribution of all population 3 survivors are similar to that of dark matter. And from this figure, what you can see from this figure is ratio between the number density of population 3 stars and dark matter density as a function of the center as a function of the distance from the halo center. And four different curves shows the result from four different Milky Way sized halos. So you can see if this curve is flat, in the case of flat curve, the distribution of dark matter and population 3 survivors are same. But population 3 survivors are slightly more concentrated than dark matter. Overall distribution is similar, but slightly show higher concentration. But if we limit the pre-band apparent magnitude, the distribution is different from that of all survivors. This map shows the distribution of survivors with V-band magnitude brighter than 22.5 and 20. This is very different from that of all survivors. The concentration distribution on subhalos are invisible simply because subhalo is far from the observer. So even if the survivors in subhalos are very bright stars, their apparent magnitude would be faint. Next, they estimates the required sample sizes to detect one population 3 survivors in four different target fields. Target fields is shown in color area. Red is high latitude field, orange is middle latitude, green is low latitude field, and this small blue region is central field. We extract the stellar and metallicity distribution of the Milky Way of these four fields using online interface of the stellar population synthesis model for the Milky Way, B-SANCON. So we can calculate the required sample size in these four fields. This is our highlight result. The required sample size as a function of the V-band apparent limiting apparent magnitude. And different four different solid curve shows four different fields. And the color is corresponding to this map. And dashed dotted line shows that dotted line obtained from by multiplying by a factor of 10 to solid curve, which means dotted curve shows one population 3 star per mini halo model, and the solid curve is 10 population 3 model, 10 population 3 stars per mini halo model. And we only count stars with apparent V-band magnitude larger than 17, because most of survivors have a magnitude of this value. So you can see higher latitude fields means red and orange curve require small sample sizes compared to lower latitude field. In spite of the number of survivors is higher in central region. This is simply because field stars are more concentrated, show more concentrated distribution to the hero center compared to survivors. In other words, the field star in central region are too many. We also show available and future observations as a cross point. Available observations like Hamburg ESO survey and SEGWE are shown here. And these observations have not, if these observations have not detected any survivors, the formation models of low mass population stars with larger than 10 stars per mini halo are already excluded. Next, we consider the future observations like SUBARU PFS, which is prime focus spectrograph. It allows simultaneous spectral observation of about 2,000 targets in about 1 square degree and will be under operation 2019. If we have one night, the result will be here. And if we have 10 nights, the result will be here. So this means if we have one night, we can constrain the number of low mass population 3 stars per mini halos is less than 1 stars per mini halos. And if we have 10 nights, we can constrain less than 0.1, the level of less than 0.1 low mass population 3 stars per mini halo. So the higher latitude fields require lower sample sizes because of the high number density of stars in the galactic disk. But the number of survivors itself is small in higher latitude fields. So this means it may be practical if we observe more lower latitude fields using photometric classifications. If we assume that photometric classification with optimized narrow band filters could exclude 95% of stars with this metallicity, so the sample size can be reduced by factors of these values. Because metallicity of disk is higher than halos, the number of stars, the number of field stars in disk lower latitude fields could be reduced more efficiently. So if we consider these reductions, the sample size in high and middle latitude fields are comparable. Even in these large factors, lower latitude field and central field require a large number of samples. So we can say, using photometric classifications, the sample sizes in the high and middle latitude fields is comparable, and these classifications can enhance the efficiency of follow-up spectroscopy. So this is our final result. So the galaxy is also a promising target. Because survivors distribute more concentrate. This, what you can see from this figure is average number of population 3 stars per subhalos as a function of the subhalo position from the halo centers. And the different 3 curves show the different subhalo mass bin 10 to the 8 to 9, 10 to the 7 to 8. 10 to the 6 to 7 solar mass subhalos. And we only count survivors with absolute V band magnitude smaller than 2, corresponding to the red giant stars. If the dwarf galaxies have a common dark matter mass of 10 to the 7 solar mass, means between blue, green and red curves, the required number of dwarf galaxies to find one population 3 stars is less than 10 at within 100 kiloparsecs. But currently, about 30 dwarf galaxies are discovered, but no population 3 survivors has been detected. This means this result disfavor 10 population, low mass population 3 stars per Miharos, disfavor this model, but is consistent with one population 3 star per Miharo. And this fact is qualitatively agreement the observations of HEROS. So here, let me summarize my talk. Thank you.
So thanks for this overview of survival rates of population 3 stars. Are there questions in the audience?
Nice. Oh, yeah, results. I'm just wondering, you have shown the spatial distribution of POP3 survivors in a Milky Way-sized halo. So what makes you confident that this actually represents the spatial distribution in the Milky Way? So have you checked other things like the merger history or, yeah, how do you know that your simulation represents the spatial distribution in our Milky Way?
So in answer to your questions, so we only checked 4 different Milky Way sized halos. So as you pointed out, the variation of merger histories and the evolution of Milky Way sized halos is the variation is maybe smaller than the overall distributions. So we have to check using more larger simulations and many number of Milky Way sized halos to check our result, whether it is confident or not. But we believe the whole difference between 4 Milky Way sized halos we checked is not large. Qualitative result is the same.
So let's thank the speaker again.